What supermodel looks exactly like an evil Winx character? What Marvel actress would completely nail the part of Princess Aisha? Stick around to find out who we think should have been cast in Netflix's new series, Fate, The Winx Saga. Bloom, Madeleine Petch, Sadie Sink. We didn't think that we would see an animated Nickelodeon series get a live-action reboot from streaming giant Netflix, but here we are. It might seem like fairies and their drama is just for kids, but think again, folks. Fate, the Winx Saga, is about to flip the script on what we think we know about these winged little creatures. Bloom is the fairy of the Dragonflame, which might explain why she's got a full head of red hair. In the original show, she is one of the most important members of the Winx Club, not only just because she helped to found it, but also because she's hella powerful. Netflix has cast relative newcomer Abigail Cohen as Bloom, but you know what? There's someone else that could probably do an incredible job. Yes, it's Riverdale's red-haired beauty herself, Madeleine Petch. We already know that Madeleine can cope under the pressure of a successful show, so it seems like a no-brainer. Plus, she has the look. On the flip side, Madeleine wouldn't be our only contender for the part if we were in charge of casting. What about Stranger Things alum Sadie Sink? She's powerful, confident, and about the right age to sink her teeth into another teen drama, seeing as she's 18 now. But in an ideal world, who would she be cast alongside? Stella, Sabrina Carpenter. As a character, Stella has a lot going on. Not only is she the fairy of the shining sun, but she's also the sole heir to the Solarian royal throne. We're not sure how that's all going to play out in the live-action series, but we do know that Hannah van der Westhuizen is set to play the character. If you don't know Hannah, don't panic. We don't either. The blonde beauty is on the up and up, and it looks like this is her first big role. But sorry, Hannah, we think we know someone who might have done it better. Sabrina Carpenter is kind of a big deal, with over 23.8 million followers and counting on Instagram. Not only does Sabrina have the vibe that Stella has, but she also has the star power. Honestly, it's a shame that she wasn't even considered for the role. Clearly, casting directors were sleeping on this one. Flora, Dana Paola, Madison Reyes. Okay, if we had to pick a favorite Winx character, it would have to be Flora. Before you come for us, we love all these fairies, but there's something about Flora that just hits different. As the guardian fairy of Lynfia, she's all about potions and magic. So who has Netflix chosen to represent our gorgeous Latina guardian? That's where things get a little bit controversial. White actress Elliot Salt was chosen to play Flora, but the character's name was changed to Tara. Understandably, fans are angry that Netflix didn't choose a talented Latina actress to play the part. If we had it our way, we would offer Madison Reyes the role in a heartbeat. Madison has proven with Julie and the Phantoms that she has what it takes to really stand out, and we would love to see more of her. But even Madison could have some stiff competition, as Dana Paola would knock it out of the park too. Paola has been in the business for years, and at 25, she's a little bit older than some of the other cast members, but it doesn't matter. She stars in the popular Spanish thriller Elite, so when it comes to teen drama, she really knows her stuff. If you think this fantasy casting choice is epic, just wait. We've got more where this came from. Musa, Lana Condor. Ah, Musa, just like her name suggests, this fairy is all about singing and hitting all the right notes. Plus, she has a super rocky on-off relationship with her boyfriend, Riven. Musa is supposed to be an Asian character, but Netflix decided to cast white actress Alicia Applebaum. Just like with Flora's casting choice and name change, fans were irritated by this to say the least. So, in a perfect world, how would we fix this situation? Let's see. There's one girl we know that's A, super talented, and B, already has plenty of experience with on-screen relationship drama. It's the one and only Miss Lara Jean herself, Lana Condor. We can't even describe just how perfect Lana would be for this role. She has a kind of pixie fairy vibe about her already, so casting her would be a no-brainer. Honestly, maybe Netflix should have taken a back seat and left this up to us. Tecna, Millie Bobby Brown. As the fairy of technology, Tecna is kind of a badass. She's ready to come up with a plan and swoop in and save the day whenever she's needed. Does that remind you of anyone you know? Well, we don't know if this character is going to be involved in Fate, Winx Saga at all. We haven't heard any official news about if she's going to be included, so at the moment, the role could still be blank. In that case, we would take care of this in a heartbeat. Takes control, is always there to save the day, is basically a feminist icon. Millie Bobby Brown would completely nail this part. Not only has she proved that she's a match for the Mind Flayer in Stranger Things, but she's also kicked butt in a corset in Enola Holmes. Millie is beyond perfect for this part, so why hasn't Netflix called her yet? In fairness, Millie is in demand, so we wouldn't be surprised if her schedule is just too packed right now. Or who knows, maybe she'll pop up in season 2. Aisha, Zendaya, Yara Shahidi. Crown Princess Aisha is also known as Princess Layla in some versions of the original show, so if you're hella confused, then don't worry. We're talking about the same character. Aisha wasn't always a member of the Winx Club and actually joined the show in the second season, but Netflix has decided to put her in from the very beginning in their version. Thankfully, producers gave the role to a super talented woman of color, Precious Mustafa. We can't wait to see what this newcomer does with the part, but who else could be just as good? Zendaya has shown audiences time and time again that she's super versatile and capable of doing drama, superhero movies, and even playing addicts. We would love to see her playing Princess Aisha, but realistically, Zendaya is just too big to be messing around with new, risky shows. So who else could be up for the challenge? What about Blackish star Yara Shahidi? Not only is Yara on the up and up in the industry, but we already know she loves fantasy. She told W Magazine in 2016 that she adores Marvel and the comic books, so would love to play a superhero. Alright, Princess Aisha isn't exactly a caped crusader, but it's pretty close. Darcy, Elizabeth Gillies. Every teen drama has to have villains that bring the drama, right? That's where the famous trio of witches comes in. Darcy is the latest threat out of herself, Stormy, and Icy, but we'll get to them later. At the moment, it isn't clear if Netflix is going to be introducing these characters straight away, but if they're looking for someone to play the mischievous witch, then we've got a suggestion. Elizabeth Gillies has been busy in Hollywood for years now, starring in Dynasty as well as other movies and TV shows. She even starred in Victorious alongside Ariana Grande. But there's something else. Elizabeth actually voiced the part of Daphne in the original Winx Club series between 2011 and 2014, so she knows the characters. It would be incredible to see her switch it up and play one of the bad guys for once. If Dynasty taught us anything, it's that Elizabeth can be mean when she wants to be. We can't imagine that the new series would be the same without the witches. It's probably only a matter of time before they pop up, but what about the other mystical mischiefs? Icy, Dove Cameron. We've already met the first member of the Trix, but Darcy isn't the meanest by a long shot. Actually, that title could be held by Icy. It's a pretty fitting name considering this witch has a heart of ice and isn't afraid to use it. Fans are literally going wild trying to get some info on whether this trio will be included, but it looks like we'll have to wait. There are rumors that the Trix has actually been merged into one single character called Beatrix, but the jury is out on that one. Anyway, it's pretty obvious who should play Icy, isn't it? Dove Cameron played the daughter of Maleficent in Disney's hit Descendants franchise, and even though she turned out to be good, she showed us there were so many ways to be wicked. If you compare the animated version of Icy to Dove, they do look strikingly similar, too. Dove has a sultry vibe that could easily make her a deadly opponent. It's just a dream at this point, but you've got to admit, Dove's big eyes and heart-shaped face are as close as it gets to a living cartoon character. Stormy, Cara Delevingne. Rounding up our trio of bad girls is Stormy, the youngest out of all three witches, but she's also the one that is the most ruthless. In an ideal world, we would pay Cara Delevingne whatever she wanted to take on this part. Sure, Cara is a model, but she's also an actress. She's been in tons of Hollywood movies and actually already has experience playing a fairy in Amazon Prime's Carnival Row. While her character in that show is actually good, it could be great to see Cara play a bad fairy looking to cause a little trouble. Remember how interesting she was as Enchantress in the 2016 DC movie? Cara is always game to take on any new roles that catch her interest, but something tells us she won't pop up in Fate, the Winx Saga, anytime soon. That doesn't stop us from hoping, though. Just look at Stormy's cheekbones and tell us Cara doesn't look just like her. What do you think? Would you cast our choices in a hot second, or would you choose someone else? Let us know your thoughts in the comments.